So this is Goose Island State Park. Each of these is a spot. The object is to back up next to this so you can hook up to the electric there. And your grill is right here. Up into here, and you've got the bay right behind you. Got the bridge over here. And I apologize for the dirty windshield, I gotta clean that. But for right now, you're kind of stuck with that. See, there's a bunch of white caps. Ooh, and there's water spraying all the way up here. There's this string down here, 26 through 40, I believe, something like that. Construction here right now. They're working on the road across through here. Looks like it might have been washed out or something, or got close to being washed out. And there's a whole bunch of houses right over here. See, more bay on that side. Probably want to make reservations, because as you can see, there's a limited number of sites that face the bay out here to the right. There's the ones back behind that we already went to, and then these along here, then the restrooms right up here, men's and women's, handicap accessible, There's a dumpster here on the left, and then more sites on the right out through here facing the big bay out the yonder and open water. And then there's also sites on the left, which is one of the ones that I stayed in last night. Because all the bay facing ones were done, full, paid for before I got here. I do want to point out there's a pier. Excuse me, there's a pier up here. 1600 foot, he said. And there are, the water is splashing pretty good. But yeah, 1600 feet of pier that you can fish from. Looks like it is wheelchair accessible. I'm gonna see if I can't get a picture of that pier rules there. Hold on just a moment. And of course, you got a view of those houses over there and the more can be constructed. Now, this Goose Island State Park looks like a bunch of the residents here in the area got together and petitioned somebody or had a friend in the government or something that made this a state park, because if I leave a video going long enough, you'll see that houses are pretty much interspersed along through the state park. So there's people that live in houses that are what I would think of as inside the state park. But that's okay, I guess. I believe the object is to save the island for the geese. Hopefully. If that's the reason for it. There's another sign there of something. Let's see if I can go ahead and take a picture of that. More restrooms, as you can see. You can see several of the back ones over here have emptied out. Ones along the bay, though. Thank you. another area where the town gets right up against the little road here by the park road, I guess you'd call it. This is the butterfly garden and the native plant garden. The birding house, I think they call it. Picnic areas over here to the right. The big tree. Here's a dump station. I don't have a trailer, but you do have water here. And there is a sewage dump, so you can dump your black water tanks and your gray water tanks. And it looked like there was potable water infilled there. I'm positive on that. Bear in mind, I don't have a trailer, so I'm not that familiar with how well set up the do not enter is for the right side there. That's the entrance to the campground. This is to the wooded area of the campground. Public consumption and display of alcoholic beverages is prohibited inside the state park. Loop. Gathering firewood is also prohibited. Another dump station, I guess. This is for your tent camping. And you do need to be careful if you bring a camper back in through here about your overhead clearance. It could get awfully close in a couple of spots. It looks like they've put up little yellow reflectors to kind of draw your attention. Bathrooms over here on the left, and men's dumpster there. Place for you to dump. Oh, there's the place for you to dump. Yeah. So yeah, they got potable and non-potable water spigots there. Down this way a minute ago and then went around that little loop. I'm gonna go straight this time. This is the Lantana Loop. there's a whole bunch of nature trails for hiking and so on. I'm not sure about biking, but there are nature trails here. Have a little loop there. Lots of nice little sites here. A lot of privacy in some of these sites. Some more private than others, but all these along here look to be surrounded by a thicket, you know, so pretty good and private. All these out there here are really nice. The gate does close at 10 p.m. So, you know, for the day use, you need to be out before 10. For those that are camping, they give you a little combination to the lock. So, if you really need to, you can head out and go get whatever you need. Come back or whatever, or if you need to just evacuate the area for some reason, there is the accommodation that they give you, so you can open the lock, get out, and then lock it behind you. So that's cool. Camping sites. This is a nice airstream. It's pretty. This is a really nice camp area. If I had a trailer, I'd definitely come back here. And I may just do that in the future. Goose Island State Park. Not bad at all, guys. Not bad at all. Thicket rather than over by the bay. The bay's nice and all, but last night and today the water's really, really murky. It's not got the clear blue look to it like it sometimes does. It doesn't always get that way, but it does sometimes. But it's not that way right now. It's pretty muddy or murky. So I hope you enjoyed a little tour of the Goose Island State Park. And again, this is the entrance to the park right here. You come in over there on that side of the building, and that's why it's a do not enter right over there. The gate that they lock it at 10 o'clock. And I think it opens at 6. Alright, well, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video and hope it's useful to you if you decide to go to Goose Island State Park. Right here it is, and I hope I gave you useful information. Alright, bye-bye.